Welcome everybody. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to the second annual AMR conference and training week. At the Medical Research Foundation, we're terribly proud to be the sole funders of this unique training program.
Well, the Medical Research Foundation AMR PhD training program is unique in its breadth. It's the only training program of its type in the UK that brings many, many universities, many institutions, and students at those institutions together to work across a range of disciplines, to understand the languages of each other's research, and to come together to hopefully impact the problem of antimicrobial resistance.
I think the programme really offers something different to other cohorts. My project's based in diagnostics, but it's really good to have someone who's doing, you know, drug discovery or looking at reservoirs of resistance. And it's good because when you have a problem in your research that might not be something you've come across before, I think everyone's got so much experience and such an age range as well. So many people have so many different life experiences as well that it's good to sort of gather opinion and help from the whole cohort.
So the program's definitely had a huge impact on the research I'm doing and also, I believe, on my future career. I think it's been designed in a great way in enhancing the research we're able to do in our 4 years, but also catering towards our future career prospects. I think the leadership team giving their talks on how they have reached their positions, the challenges they've faced, have been really informative for us in kind of deciding where we want to go with our careers.
So the annual training week is split into two parts. Firstly, there's a two-day conference which is attended by the wider training cohort. This is a group of around 130, 140 students from across the UK, all four corners of the UK. And they come together, they present their work, they give posters, they talk to each other and discuss their work and get inspiration from each other about how they might work together or how they might take their work forward. And then the second part of the training week is a three-day intensive course for a group of 50 of those students who come together to learn about AMR from experts, from clinicians and scientists and policymakers, from journalists, to understand how they can study AMR, how they can communicate their research, and how they can communicate with each other and build the interdisciplinary researchers of the future.
So in our group last year, we came up with the idea of personalising AMR and death certificates. And what this will do is just really make sure that antimicrobial resistant infections are noted, maybe not as a causative agent for death, but as definitely a contributing factor. What we need to have the ability to do is track infections which are multi-drug resistant and kind of assess mortality rates based on that as well.
The Medical Research Foundation AMR program has, I think, so far had great impact on my research and career. Firstly, on the research side, there's been a very nice structure to it, which helps as someone pursuing their PhD. And then in terms of my career, I think there's great value in the interdisciplinary emphasis of the program, because I'm really developing and honing skills in a number of areas that I think I'll be able to apply in my career.
Antimicrobial resistance is a real problem of real people in real situations. And so we made it clear when we designed the training program that we would expose our students to the real world. And so, for example, when we're discussing the issue of whether antimicrobial resistance is transmitted, is spread using wastewater into rivers, into the oceans, back into people, you need to show them the realities of how sewage is processed, how wastewater treatment plants work. Otherwise, they're not going to understand the detail that you explain to them via some PowerPoint presentation.
The poster I'm presenting today is actually a collaboration that we developed at the event last year. We are collecting data in a Scottish hospital, and we've got tons of data on the epidemiology of antimicrobial resistance. My colleagues is working within the labs, so we actually got together and we've now got a little sub-project looking at whole genome sequencing.
One of the great things about this programme is it gets scientists out of their laboratory or away from their computer screen and sits them down, and we can chat and just discuss our own experiences. And I've learned a huge amount from people on the course that are working in completely different areas to me that I just would never have the chance to speak to.
It's such an important area because people die of resistant infections like every year, right now it's happening across the globe. And I think for so long we've sort of neglected the fact that AMR is such a big issue. I mean, it was predicted by Fleming in his Nobel Prize winning speech. So why has it taken us so long to sort of think about resistance and to think about how we combat it?
The Medical Research Foundation is at the moment funding 18 PhD students, paying for their entire PhDs, and they're working across four thematic areas, understanding the basic biology of antimicrobial resistance, developing technological solutions to the problem, understanding how antimicrobial resistance spreads and develops in a real-world context, in the environment, in hospitals, within people. And then finally, understanding behaviours, human behaviours, around drivers for antimicrobial resistance, what people do and what they can potentially stop doing or start doing to deal with the problem of AMR.